The next topic is partial molar quantities. The concept of partial molar quantities was introduced by Jean Lewis in 1907. What he studied? He studied the variation of a thermodynamic property for an open system in which the composition of one or more of components is varied. Here we are talking about the open system. Now, open system is what? The system which can exchange both the matter and energy with the surrounding. So, the thermodynamic property whose variation is studied with respect to the change in composition will be an extensive property. Extensive property is what? Which is depending upon the amount of substance present in the system. So here we are talking about the variation of extensive property of an open system with the change in composition of one or more components of the system. Now consider any extensive property X and your system is consisting of n constituents such that the amount of constituents in the system are n1, n2, n3 and so on. Now this extensive property will be a function of temperature, pressure as well as amount of different constituents present in the system. Now if we see the mathematical expression here, the extensive property will be a function of temperature, pressure and number of moles of different constituents. For very small change in temperature, pressure and the amount of constituents, the change in property of X will be given by this expression, where total change in X is equal to the variation of this X with temperature, keeping pressure constant and the composition of other constituents constant into dT, plus curly X by curly P at constant temperature and constant composition into dP, plus the variation of this property with change in number of moles of component 1, keeping temperature pressure constant and composition of other constituents constant into dN1 and so on. In this way, we are getting the total change in X in terms of different parameters. Now, if temperature and pressure of the systems are kept constant, we will have dT and dP equal to 0, so that total change in X at constant temperature and pressure will be equal to this. The term containing dT and dP will become now 0, so we will have the change in X at constant temperature and pressure equal to this expression. Now in this expression, the partial derivatives we are seeing here, this one, these partial derivatives are known as partial molar quantity, or you can say partial molar property. As we see the expression here, this is the partial derivative of extensive property with respect to change in number of moles of component 1, keeping temperature pressure constant and composition of other variables constant. Similarly, this is the variation of extensive property with change in the number of moles of component 2 at constant temperature, pressure and keeping composition of other constituents constant. These partial derivatives are known as partial molar property. Now as we will change this X parameter, this property may be any extensive property. As we will change any extensive property, we will get different type of partial molar properties for the given system. As we are seeing here, in general for any component we are having partial molar property given by this expression. Now if extensive property is internal energy, in that case we are getting partial molar internal energy. Similarly, if we are having extensive property as enthalpy, in that case we are having partial molar enthalpy by this expression. Similarly, we can have various thermodynamic properties as we are seeing here, if we are having entropy, in that case we will have partial molar entropy. If we are having volume, we will have partial molar volume. If we are having free energy as extensive property, in that case we are having partial molar free energy. Now, next is the chemical potential. Chemical potential is what? This is the partial molar free energy. Partial molar free energy is also known as chemical potential. So, chemical potential is what? This is the variation of free energy with change in the number of moles of a component, keeping temperature pressure constant and composition of other constituents constant. So, if we are having DNI equal to 1 mole in this equation, we will have mu is equal to change in free energy at constant temperature pressure and constant composition. So how we can define this chemical potential? Chemical potential of any constituent in a mixture is the increase in free energy at constant temperature and pressure when 1 mole of that constituent is added to the system, keeping temperature pressure constant and keeping number of moles of other constituents constant. So this will be the definition of chemical potential. Now, as you are seeing here, the mathematical expression, the change in free energy at constant temperature and pressure will be given by this expression, or you can write this is equal to mu 1 dN1 plus mu 2 dN2 and so on. So for a system of definite composition, when the composition is definite, there is fixed amount of N1, N2, N3 and so on. In that case, total free energy of the system will be equal to N1 into mu1 plus N2 mu2 plus N3 mu3 and so on. So what we can say, mu1, mu2, mu3 give the contribution per mole to the total free energy of the system. So these are the contribution per mole for each constituents to the total free energy of the system. Thus we can define the chemical potential as the contribution per mole of any constituent to the total free energy of the system of a constant composition at constant temperature and pressure. Now one thing we can see here, free energy is an extensive property, whereas chemical potential is an intensive property. In general, what you can say, extensive properties are having variation with change in number of moles giving us the partial molar properties, and these partial molar properties are intensive properties. For example, free energy is an extensive property, whereas chemical potential is an intensive property. Thank you.